There's no place to escape to.
This is the last street.
On the left.
That's when the cannibalism started.
What was that?
Absolutely. Hey, what's
because
up?
Of a certain belief system that people have about the sharks.
Okay, it's Shark Week, everyone.
And people need to know that they're not just killers. They're misunderstood.
They aren't just killers. They don't even kill many people. We kill a heck of a lot more sharks than they kill us.
I kill That's a lot true. More than any sharks ever killed.
All right. Hey, everyone.
We kill more of everything than what kills us. We kill more dogs, kill more cows. We kill more marmots.
I do believe. No, fuck the marmot. Fuck the marmot.
Oh, wow.
Because of the fucking Black Plague series. The marmot can go fuck itself. But honestly, if we threw more dogs into the ocean, more sharks would eat dogs.
I bet you that... Cats kill more than people. Cats are serial killers. Yeah, we don't.
They wish they could.
Yeah, I guess they don't factory farm their birds. Okay, I'm Ben, hanging out with Henry and Marcus.
That's me. It's my mandate this week.
This is your mandate. Look at that big old hand, Mr. Marcus. Big
yeah.
old hand.
Oh.
Yeah, that could pleasure 8 to 15 sharks right there.
Yeah. Oh.
10 boys, I finger.
You know the hard thing about dating a shark? They never stop moving.
It is really hard. Come it's back. Hard to pin one down.
Come
Rolling
back.
Stones.
Yep.
Don't gather no moss.
Although I did learn this. When a penguin, if one of the ladies dies, the dude doesn't fuck any more chicks. But if a male penguin dies, that woman is out on the town getting her
Girl
groove
boss.
Back.
Huh.
Also, is penguins are gay.
Yeah,
some can
they
be.
Can be. They can be. And another myth buster, sharks can get cancer.
Well, how'd you find that out?
I saw a picture of a shark with a big tumor.
Oh,
on the side of its
head. The aluminum and the deodorant.
Oh, I thought it was going to be like a shark getting his hair cut, but then somebody who's cutting his hair also cuts their own hair, and then the shark cries. Have you ever seen that?
What?
It's all the trend. If you have cancer, you have to shave your head after chemo, right? Or before chemo. So you might as well just shave it off. And so people shaving the person's head, then they'll take the razor after they shave a little bit, and they shave their own head. And then the person who has cancer is like, I can't believe you do that.
A shark
me.
Doesn't have hair.
Yeah. No, it might have fine hair. It actually might have fine hair.
A shark does not have fine hair. It's
we
a creature of cartilage.
It's not
it
a
doesn't
have,
actually
doesn't
don't
have
know. I'm
skin
actually
gonna... as we understand it. It's cartilage.
You wait until Google validates me. Duh,
because shark skin. Shark skin is a thing. I have heard of shark skin, like a shark skin wallet, shark
of
skin
course.
Boots.
Also, what up to the chat? People saying a lot of different animals can be gay. I'm certain. My rude Dooner's up in there. We got the promo shots from fucking Dune coming out there. What's going on, bros? We're doing it again. Dune is only going to be... I think Dune's going to come out finally in 2023.
Nice.
Yeah,
well,
it's going to be great.
I can't wait. Sharks, they don't have hair because
they
they're
don't.
Not mammals.
No, they don't have hair. We knew that, though.
Yeah.
We knew that. Marcus and I knew that.
We knew that. Well, let's start it off with
fish
a quick...
Fish have hair, though.
They
fish
don't have
do,
fucking hair.
Fish
yes,
do not have
hair.
Hair
cells in fish are used to detect water movements around their bodies. These hair cells are embedded in a jelly-like protrusion called the cupula.
Honestly, Coopula. I guess he is reading Coopula. It off. He's reading it off his phone, so you know it's real. Like, he did read it right there. There's no way.
Yep.
Oh, from study.com. So that's really good.
No, that was the one that said that you guys were right. This was from Wikipedia that says you guys were wrong.
Okay.
All right,
let's
Marcus,
start it off with a quick
mandate.
One. Let's do a quick
okay.
one.
Hi, Mike.
What's up, Chad?
Oh. Chad.
Now, how is he doing that?
I want to see it reverse now.
Yeah, can
I
we want to play
see it the other
can
way.
Can we play it reversed?
Yeah, play it the other way.
Is it even possible?
Can you do it?
Maybe
with
we can rewind it.
Isn't that the tech that they used in that movie Tenet, and then they got an award for it because they reversed everything? Nope, Fernando cannot reverse on the flight. That's why Tenet got the Oscar. All right, let's
That's
watch
true.
It again. Maybe you can
That's
try
true.
To reverse it in your own mind.
Yeah, try
I
it.
Yes, you can.
Let's see it.
Okay, so we got one bottle of Coke there.
Now some Mentos. It's a Mentos Coke.
I just wanted
Coke
to hear it make the noise.
Okay. Well, all right. Very nice. Great first video.
Thank you.
Have you ever done that with any kind of Coca-Cola products or anything like
Can't
that?
Can't say that I ever have. I've never gotten around to it.
I'm a little bit sick of the Mentos in soda.
It has been done. Yeah.
We know what the scientific
it's been
thing
done.
Is. We get it. I know.
It's not impressive anymore. We've seen it. It's over.
It's still such a popular thing. It's like, that's what happens. We know.
That is done for me.
Shove it up your ass and do it.
Yeah, I'd love to see you fucking blow your asshole out with it, but I think you'd get a yeast infection or something. But I will say, you know what I'm also done with? Natalie and I have, this is our new litmus test for horror movies. We'll watch all horror movies, but as soon as a scene comes on that has like, dun, 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 like a child song played creepily,
we're done.
You're done.
Done. You know what I'm done with?
That knocks out Nightmare on Elm Street.
It's, I'm talking new. I'm talking post-2021.
New. You know what I'm done with? I'm done with grief. I'm done with grief.
What?
Like in horror movies? Grief?
Every horror movie has a, every main character is always dealing with grief. Always
it's
dealing
a
with
horror a, movie.
Well, Hereditary. Hereditary made it mainstream. Yeah.
What are you talking about? Hereditary, do you want them to be Babadook. Happy?
Babadook also. I'm not talking about after the murder. I'm talking about as a baseline thing. Whereas like Babadook is all about, you know, that's a metaphor for grief. And Hereditary is all about grief. Both of those movies are fucking great.
Dark and the Wicked's about grief.
Yeah, but I just watched The Empty Man, which is pretty good. But the only thing is that the main character, his whole thing is that he's grieving for somebody.
He's grieving. It's all what are you talking about?
It's always
that's
about
supposed to
grief.
Make you empathize with the person because all of us have experienced grief. See, it's an empathy. Like it's an end point.
I like when you're having a good time. Find a different thing. Hereditary really made it. Like Midsommar, right? Yeah. Midsommar. You have the whole scene where she's going like, she
that
does
was
that big
not
crying
grief.
Scene. That is grief.
No, that was her being horrified because she's in a nightmare land where all the old people die, which actually now makes it kind of cool.
It's the grief section when she's mad about the something happened to her. I forget what happened to her, where somebody died and everyone's like, well, because I understand that she was annoying.
This is a massive emotion that you guys want to get out of movies. You guys sound like Chinese leaders right now. This is communist China.
Are you talking about successful neo-capitalists?
Wow.
I'm not saying get it out of the movies completely. I'm just saying as a baseline. You can't start it at the baseline of, oh, I'm grieving, I'm so full of grief, everything's so horrible. I'm saying they can grieve in the movie for something that happens in the movie, but when they're just grieving the whole time, I'm tired of it.
Hear
How
me
about
out.
Hashtag grieving, right? Where you do a thing
leaving,
where it's cool.
I'm leaving the grieving.
Make it cool to grieve.
Hashtag leaving the grieving. Put it on the show.
Oh, yeah, her whole family died. Yeah, that's right. I forgot, because they all committed
her
suicide.
Her whole family is dead, and you're saying that she shouldn't feel bad. Hear me out on this, though.
I didn't say she shouldn't feel bad.
Marmaduke meets Babadook in one of the most classic films of all time.
Oh, huh. Marmaduke, the new gay horror icon.
Marmaduke meets Babadook. Marmaduke v. Babadook. I think Marmaduke has a chance to win.
People are mad because they're saying hashtag trolling. People are like, this is just how it is. This is just how it is. We're just, these are
leaving the grieving.
Listen, we're trying to leave some grieving. I honestly, you know what I want to see more horror movies based upon? Hunger. I'm hungry for a hamburger. But we stop at a stand. Evil hamburger stand rapes everybody.
Yeah, but that's not even. But then it doesn't make any.
Hungry.
It's just
for
a strange
horror.
Emotion. It's a weird emotion, especially in the genre that we love the most, which is horror. It's just a weird emotion to get out of horror because that would almost make it would be like getting the idea of being horny out of comedy. Where do you go?
They've already done that. That is gone.
Yeah, that is gone. Isn't Thinner about hunger?
He gets to be hungry.
He gets to be hungry, but the first half of that movie is a straight up, it is, what's difference of horror?
Him smashing food into his face, but I love that about that movie.
What's the opposite of like watching a bunch of people get devastated? Just watching, because the first half of that movie when he eats and he's still losing weight and his wife is like, you look so good, and he's like, yeah. And then I'm like, that's the coolest fucking thing of all time.
Yeah, but the problem is that it goes too far.
Yeah, but the first half of that movie was splendid. Splendid.
Yeah. Well, watch Raw. Someone says they're a hug bear.
Oh, yes,
watch Raw. And also the other movie that I saw last night, made by that they have a new movie coming out. My Heart Can't Beat Unless You Tell It To is actually also technically about hunger.
Also, I watched a comedy horror called Too Late with Ron Lynch. And he plays someone who is quite hungry, perhaps.
Oh, yeah. Oh, it's about being greedy, Wacky Deli says.
What?
Raw Meat. Raw Meat is also great. Raw Meat with, I think, Donald Pleasance is in
Raw
it.
Raw Meat
it's,
is good.
Yeah,
Thinner's
it's
not about being
wonderful.
Greedy. Thinner is not about being greedy.
It's
Thinner,
about being greedy.
No, it's about revenge because he freaking ran over a damn witch.
But before then, it was because she...
He was getting blown by his wife.
She incisively saw the thing. That mean, he did get blown by his wife.
It's obviously not greed. She didn't fuck with his money. It's food related.
And it's greed. It's not just money, Kissel. Gluttony. You're being purposefully. You're being purposefully
simple. I just
disagree
with the comment on that.
Purposefully simple.
It's just not about greed.
I love Annihilation.
Vaporizer. That movie is about greed. And the movie Greed is about greed.
It's because it's called Greed.
It's called Thinner because it's about food.
You're shaking everything with your rage. You're shaking this whole room with your rage.
If I was, this is why I can't date. Because if I was on a date, I'd be like, I don't know. It doesn't really seem to play out that way. But I guess there is some greed involved.
I got something for you right now. This is going to satiate your rage. Okay. This is some good old-fashioned amateur wrestling with weed whackers.
Oh, my
God. Oh, fuck
guys,
yeah.
This is how you die. This is seriously. Please, guys, there's no one there. You don't have to do this, guys. Already covered in his own blood.
It's so fucking sweet.
There's no need to do this, guys.
Well, they're not like...
No, they are. This is...
Well, they're not bladed, right? I don't think they're bladed.
But, dude, those...
Yeah, they are. They're wrapped. They got the wrappers.
Dude, those that plastic shit, that...
What is the point of this, guys? What story are you telling here? What is the audience supposed to take away from this? What an atrocious idea.
That's fucking so sweet.
I love it. If you're in the audience, you're like, okay. And it was called Slam-a-Fan. Slammed Fan. Okay, Slam-a-Fan. Well, check out Slam-a-Fan.
What, did they just attack each other? Is that the whole fight?
Yeah, that's the one thing with the hardcore wrestling. Sometimes they lose the storytelling aspect. Sometimes they'll lose, like, why? What's my motivation here? Sometimes they just hit each other with weed whackers.
But
which does look
too?
Like it hurts, but also I don't know what I'm supposed to get out of it.
Yeah.
But it's cool. It's cool.
It definitely hurts. Oh, no, you're going to be breaking some skin. You might actually, you could go down to the bone with a weed whacker.
Sweet. You could die. Without a doubt, they could die.
I remember staying up at night. Because they used to have, I forgot what wrestling show was at night, and they used to have the Extreme
ECW.
Championship wrestling. It was that
ECW,
after,
ECW
it's like,
in Philly.
It would
Philly.
Be late at night, and they would like everybody would get all bloody and jump on each other. Like,
that's ECW,
I fucking loved that shit as a kid.
Woo, that show is dirty.
Yeah, it's very dirty.
But it's that dirty? Why is it that dirty?
Oh, that show was trash-tastic. I mean, that was Philly, that was just straight up like... boobies that were kind of like belonging on the back of a bike. You know those jerk-off mags
like
that you would
kinds.
Look at and you were like, none of these people are attractive, but also like the fact they're such filthy whores makes it really hot.
I love boobies with character.
But,
like,
you know,
boobies with character,
yes, exactly.
Like a little bit more of a story here. Like
boobies that have seen a paycheck. Boobies that have seen a rent bill come. And
I like, that's what I like. A boobies that tell a story.
Yeah,
yeah.
I'm
the
with
kind
you.
That, the kind that have like the little... wrinkles on the side because the silicone's been in there so long.
I love them.
Brings it. Yeah.
I love them. I got no problems with it. I like the boobies that look like a lost childhood. I like boobies that look like you made a lot of money recently. I like boobies that are like, tell me your story. Tell me your story, boobies.
Sure.
And then you just go like, tell me. Tell me your story.
Yes, indeed. And they can scream.
I got a story for you. They could scream. Every story is better screamed. That is true.
The boobies that we're talking about, they would scream because, you know, they're like the bus driver from South Park. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah. I know what you're saying. I'm
Mrs.
saying boobies.
What was her name? Not jokes on Dick.
No, that I don't know if she had a name?
It. Mrs. Crabapple or something?
No, it's something similar, though. You're getting there. Okay.
But you also like the idea of a boobie that just likes to smoke a long cigarette and talk for a long time.
Do you remember that trope in porn? I don't think it really exists so much anymore because smoking's not really in vogue.
Oh, yeah. There's still plenty of smoking porn.
Yeah.
There's plenty of it. Oh,
yes. There's a whole category for it.
It was kind of nice as a young boy because, number one, A, you know that you're talking to a mature lady who has a lot to think about.
Oh, yeah. Bacademic says, I like boobies that just took a load.
Okay.
And it's really great.
And then smoking there. But anyway, smoking, you don't really see it as much.
That's really, really
good. No, you really don't. You really don't. Okay. But this next one, this next video, this is something you also don't see as much. You don't see as many animatronics.
Oh, yeah. Also, it's probably good to check your moves. If you're a man, check your moves for lunch.
Absolutely.
For bumps. Check them for lunch.
Flat.
If you could get in here, because sometimes I do soup does get in here and food particles do get in here. But it's also very important to feel them for lumps, because if not, that's just besides fucking prostate cancer, it's just a rough way to go.
Veronica Crabtree.
Pasquale? Only kidding, Chucky. I've changed my tune because I finally thought of a possible dream that we can all share.
What is it? Pasquale?
It's a dream about a world where nobody is poor or sick. Or hungry.
Oh, now that's a dream we can make come true.
I'm gonna make a change for once in my life. It's gonna feel real good. Gonna make a difference. Gonna make it right.
All of us have stared in the mirror listening to this song.
As I point up the collar on my favorite winter coat.
Big Mouth is really butchering it. Yeah.
He's too much in character. In the street, with not enough to eat, who am I to be blind, pretending not to see them?
Take this song literally and really look in the mirror. What am I doing? They follow each other on the wind, you know, because they got nowhere to go. That's why I want you to know.
Thank you. I'm with the man in the
mirror. This isn't him talking
the lyrics at all.
No, they didn't. No, because it is about a man regretting all his life choices.
Some chunky bass lines on this version, too. Really up front in the mix.
The dog is the bass player. Oh. Looks like one of those little monsters that used to come. Remember those?
Oh, yeah, look at that. Look at their horrible nightmare eyes.
And make a change. These are all Chuck E. Cheese characters. I don't remember any of these other than that one.
Yeah.
I never paid attention to the animatronics at Chuck E. Cheese.
I never went to a Chuck E. Cheese.
You've never been?
No.
I went to a Fuddruckers.
We had Pistol Pete's.
Pistol Pete's?
Yeah.
Pistol Pete's?
He was a basketball player.
Come down to Pistol Pete's and hide his secrets for him.
Yeah, I'm not going to Pistol Pete's.
No, come down to Pistol Pete's, he'll give you a gun to hold and something else as well.
Are you 10?
We have Pistol Pete's in Lubbock, and Abilene had Crystals. Which
I know
had
Crystals.
There was a real weird dark room in the back where they would just play Looney Tunes cartoons on repeat, but it was always dark and it was always really creepy.
Cool.
I didn't like going in there at all.
Because you know, it's just some man has been like, put some cartoon ones on and some kids are like.
Yeah, because the kid, by the time he was the kid's age, he was in WW2 fighting along everyone else, beating up the Nazis and stuff, and he doesn't know what kids like.
Mm-hmm. Put a cartoon on in a dark room. Like. It's weird because he always looked the cartoons from, like, even just our childhood. Like, remember the B-level Saturday morning cartoons where, like, they were either on before or after the main
well, that depends.
Section
like
Saturday
Snorks?
Morning
cartoons? Yeah, what do you... Oh, yeah. Oh, I bet you think that Jem was B as well.
I think that Jem was not B because Jem technically had a big marketing deal and had a lot of toys.
Yes, and yeah. I thought the Snorfs were fantastic.
They were not.
That was based off a Snorf from He-Man.
Yeah, they stole it.
No, you're thinking of, I said Snorks. Snorks.
Snorks.
Snarf
Snorks
is
sucks.
Snarf is in and Snarf.
Snarf is
Thundercats.
From the yeah, he's Thundercats.
Snarf's in Thundercats. You're thinking of Orko.
I'm Snork. Snorks suck.
Yeah, you're right. Now that I look at these Snorks are pieces of shit.
It was a Smurfs knockoff.
Remember that cartoon? It was
right.
Wayne Gretzky and Michael Jordan and
the All-Stars.
That was sweet as hell.
That
too.
Was actually
that was
really
a good
one.
Bo Jackson, I believe, was in that.
Yeah, Bo Jackson.
Damn. I remember an episode where they were Wayne Gretzky skated a like all throughout like a skyscraper that was still getting built.
It was called Pro Stars. Starring Michael Jordan, Wayne Gretzky,
my boy.
And Bo Jackson. That show was awesome.
Man, I bet they still get together for lunch.
You know what I've heard is not so
wouldn't
awesome?
Wouldn't that be fun to go to lunch with those guys?
Yeah.
I think it would be... Bo Jackson, what he does now is he makes his own arrows and he goes game hunting, but he does it the right, authentic way where he uses a bow and arrow and it's all good with the way he does it. And then Michael Jordan, that would be scary.
Well, I don't know if he'd talk a lot.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I would imagine Michael Jordan would have his meal, not say as little as possible, and then leave and tell you at the end of it that you wasted his time.
I feel like it depends on what the circumstances are. Are we there because I have cancer? And it was my one wish and you get to do it? Because he will probably still sit in silence.
No, I think
but then he'll go like, you just keep jumping. You know, like he'll like do like a thing like afterwards. Like, right. Well, you know, hope you don't die right after this. So.
Maybe when he leaves, he'll do his jump man.
I don't think he does that anymore. He's out there. He's already done it.
I actually think that kids know that Michael Jordan isn't that. I love Michael Jordan, but I think kids with cancer know he's not that kind of athlete. He's not showing up. No kids have ever asked for Michael Jordan.
I think that
Charles Barkley will show up. No, I don't. Honestly, I don't think that Michael will show up.
I saw
Shaquille
one video
O'Neal
of him.
Will show up.
She, of course, absolutely.
Dude, well, have you heard? He loved to be nude back in the day. Apparently, he only walked around the locker rooms naked. That's true. It's funny. There's a new book out. Apparently, it's,
I bet he's
not bad. It was just a bunch of boys doing boy stuff. But there was one person who was on his team saying he could have been nude a little less.
Oh yeah, Street Sharks comes up. Street Sharks also fucking ruled.
Street Sharks was
cool. Street Sharks fucking that was a sweet ass fucking show.
Mask that movie. That
they're saying they can't hear us. Can you hear us?
Can you hear us?
Can you hear me?
Oh my gosh! If they can't hear us,
can you even see me? Oh yeah, you guys are—we're fine. Well, gargoyles,
you were lied to. Henry was lied to. He believed the chat right away. Did you hear that, Marcus?
I didn't mean to. I don't always though.
Disinformation. Is that disinformation or misinformation?
I think when you're punching up, it's disinformation. But when you're punching down, well, it's still, when you're punching up, it's misinformation. When you're punching down, it's disinformation.
Gargoyles was really a solid show. Do you remember the live action Beauty and the Beast?
Yeah. It was creepy. Yeah, with Ron Perlman.
Right? Yes.
With Ron Perlman. Yeah, fucking that woman. And I do like those
when
stories
I fall
when
in
you
love
really
with being with a beast, but like, I love that lady.
We did that bit about that on the live show once, but the idea of like, because that really just shows she's fucking a warthog.
She is. Yeah, she was legally doing that.
Yeah, she really was.
But again, ladies, princes in real life, they're not handsome.
They're not. Yeah. No, they're inbred.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, this next video, this is a man, I don't want to call him a beast because that's rude, but he is one of the largest men on the face of the planet. And you got to watch.
He's pushing 8 feet tall. I've seen this video. He's pushing 8 feet tall. He's a very, very big man. I've actually kind of wondered about showing this video myself because it is a little bit about the trials and tribulations of some of our larger people.
It ain't easy, man. At least I got the veins that go from head to toe. But if you're 8 feet tall, the veins can't go that far.
But listen, the key is be silent enough so you can hear his voice.
Yes, his voice is insane.
Una extraña malformación física generó que los gemelos Rodrigo y Javier en Guatemala nacieran con graves problemas físicos, los cuales derivaron en un incontrolable crecimiento de todo su cuerpo. Los gemelos afrontaron infinidad de extrañas enfermedades, pero Rodrigo nació con una
cabeza muy grande,
por lo que falleció cuando tenía un año y medio, mientras que Javier siguió luchando por su vida.
Porque pues ellos nacieron con un síndrome
desconocido.
Meses más tarde de la muerte de su hermano, Javier presentó una mezcla de distintos síndromes que hicieron que el joven siguiera creciendo en forma desmedida, mientras que sus huesos empezaron a torcer debido a su increíble tamaño.
No había un caso similar en el mundo. Habían 10 parecidos, pero no iguales. Entonces, eso hacía mucho más cuesta arriba la situación.
Se pensó que Javier moriría igual que su hermano. También presentaba hidrocefalia, osteoporosis y problemas para hablar. Pero en forma milagrosa se libró de la muerte y ahora intenta llevar una vida lo más normal posible.
Aquí en la casa, pongo la mesa.
I'll worship him.
Quito la mesa, doblo la ropa, la reparto, la ropa que está planchada, la reparto, ayuda mucho a mamá, cuida a mi abuelita.
Wow. Javier mide 2 metros con 35 centímetros, que necesita una cama especial y un médico estadounidense le enseñó una silla de ruedas de su tamaño para que pudiera movilizarse sin problema.
Why does a man's voice sound like, is it because his throat's bigger? He's got a lot of stuff going on in there.
Es muy comprensivo, muy inteligente.
Yeah, someone said banana shins.
Y nos cuidamos mutuamente.
Desde Guatemala, para Alarma TV, Juan Pablo García.
All right, he's signing off.
Guatemala.
That's the universal, I'm signing off. But there's no language barrier when a reporter's wrapping it up.
If you're in the chat and you have no clue, or if you know this, actually answer me. Is it because the vocal cords are thicker and the throat is bigger? And is that why they get that tight? Because, what's his name? George Mirasan kind of has that a little bit.
Yeah, you get a deeper voice the larger you are, I think.
But you are very much so. You have like a you have an announcer's voice, like you have a radio's voice, and it's deep. But you don't have like a gigantism voice.
I've never let you hear my real voice.
What is it?
Harry, fuck you.
So I mask it with this.
That is just great.
And so the brave. Oscar goes to.
Oh, yeah, because you know how you get an Oscar? Because all you have to do is show up to an audition
to
go,
pay for it.
Hello, my name's Nigel. And then they ask you to read the thing. You're like, damn it, Steve. We've got to get out of this plane. And then everyone's like, oh, he's brilliant. Look at him. He didn't sound British for fucking half a second.
Yeah, you're not. That's just nice. It's good. You are not bitter.
Every single, the Snake Eyes movie. When did the Snake Eyes movie? It's a G.I. Joe. That is the most American shit you can get. And then they cut you. Show the Snake Eyes trailer. You saw this whole thing.
You're upset with the G.I. Joe movie.
I'm just saying, it is G.I. Joe. He's a G.I. Joe. And at the very end, they do be like, it's, you know, because in the thing, he's got a normal, like, he's got American accent. So he's just like, yeah, we got to kick all these guys in the balls. And then it comes to the very end, and he's just like, hi, my name's Bibby Bobby, and I just want to say it's a very much a pleasure to be a G.I. Joe. And it's like, fuck what? You, Australian. Fuck this shit.
Well, it's fine. I'm sure he was a very talented artist. I mean, you can't, it's an international world.
I'm sure he did okay.
Bigger larynx, people are saying. Bigger larynx.
And that's maybe the thing. You got a bigger larynx with that guy. The next couple videos, we're going to be showing little tiny guys. Guys that are 18 years old, but they're little tiny guys. Little bitty tiny guys. And
this
they
is
have
great. I'm so happy you gave this. I'm so happy you gave this minefield for Henry to navigate. Let's just see how much he's learned after doing this show for 7 years. We're going to watch little people do big people stuff. Is that it?
Big ups about Dune, too. Dune's October 22nd.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a duo, but we got two different guys. This first one, his name is Abdu Rozik. They're from one of the stans. I can't remember which stan, but one of the smaller stans.
I stan that.
Yeah. Yeah. So let's listen. But listen for his very adorable voice.
I mean, the music doesn't help.
So his name is Borgir?
That's what he called the burger. He called it Borger. So this guy's like 38 years old?
No, he's 18.
Oh. Borgir. Man, what's on that burger?
Bro, give me the burger.
Honestly, that's a sad looking burger. What are there, jalapenos on there? Where's all the ketchup?
It's a wonderful one.
Truly do wish that all burgers. Someone said, yeah, I wish burgers were all that big.
Yeah.
I like this guy. This 18 round. Good for him.
That's the thing, is that this guy, the guy that we just saw, and this other guy, I believe his name is Hasbullah, called Lil Khabib, Mini Khabib.
Regulus and the chat just said, it's going to be Hasbullah, isn't it? Like, Hasbullah's coming.
It's Hasbullah. Yeah, Hasbullah. These two have got a bit of a feud going on that we'll get to in just a second. But now let's see his counterpart. These two hate each other.
Pizza. Okay, now I want. Oh, hello. Thank you. That's kind of nice. I wonder how much pizza he can eat. Okay, that's pretty normal. That's pretty nice. That's pretty right.
So they're of age. These are adults.
18 years old, apparently.
They're both 18. 18 to 20.
And what is the predicament? What pickle are they in biologically?
The predicament is that, I know the first one, Abdu, he had rickets when he was a child, and never.
Rickets.
Yeah, rickets. Don That's rickets. What rickets did. That's what rickets did to him. But these two guys, Abdu and Hasbullah, have both made friends with MMA fighters.
Yep. Of course, That's exactly. Who's going to get a big? Yep. Everybody, in all scenarios, you have to make sure you got somebody in there that you can protect you no matter what. He's too small to fight for his own. The only
you
way
have
to
have your
fight,
big. You have to have your big.
You would need a big old gun.
Yeah. So throughout their friendships with these MMA fighters, they have since gotten into MMA bouts. They have MMA bouts of their own scheduled in the future. They have not. They have not done it yet. And their Instagrams, I've been following both their Instagrams. They're wonderful because it's both shit-talking each other in a language that I can't understand at all. Mm-hmm. So, but I know they hate each other. And I know they're talking shit on each other. So this is the press conference that they had to discuss their fight.
All right. It's nice to know they're both the same age. Very fair fight.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's a similar weight class and shit. I'd love to.
Слышишь, имею уважение. Общайся нормально. Я с тобой общаюсь по-братски, только ради этого человека. Я по-мужски с тобой общаюсь, по-человечески. Я тоже могу орать.
I get. I feel this kid's energy. But then this
guy. Если бы не было его, я бы тебя.
I want to dress like this. That is the literal outfit I want.
Yeah, it's a cool outfit.
He's like, he's a nice beast.
Oh, but this guy's aggressive right off the
bat. Yeah, man, fuck, you got pop up, dude. Don't be not to fuck around, bro. Hezbollah, you get in there, bro.
Yeah, Hezbollah is definitely the more aggressive one.
That's what he wants, man. But man, his eye, oh my god, his AirPods at the side of his fucking face.
But that means that this guy's in his head, because he's the one freaking out.
Because the young guy's sitting back. But guess what, Hezbollah, you go in there and you fucking knock him in the dick. Look at him, knock those fucking AirPods out.
No, Abdu, he does look a little rattled. He definitely looks rattled.
He's a little rattled, yeah.
Well, it's because he didn't know we're going to be doing this. But guess what, man? Yeah, you brought Hezbollah. You think Hezbollah was going to fucking go off? Take off the jacket, bro. Take off the jacket, bro.
I kind of need to see this fight.
More gear. Get him, bro.
What is the spider doing? Let the guy alone. Let the guy go.
Wait, tell him. He's not a child. He's a man. He's not a child.
They must yell that every day.
That's Children of Dune. That's what the entire book is about. I need a fence. Someone send me a fence. I want to fight these two kids. Adults. I want to fight these two adults myself.
They're 18. They're still kind of
Yeah, man. You're going to fucking punch me? Punch me. Punch me, bro. That's what he's saying. Punch me. Come on.
Yeah, the kick. We got our first kick here. Look at
that. He's going to punch. Yeah, get him, bro. Come on, bro.
Let him have it.
Let him go.
Let him. He's seen the kick. He's
cheap.
Yeah.
He didn't come dressed to fight. He's got a nice jacket on and shit. Hezbollah's sitting there fucking smirking. Whatever, dog.
He smirks too much.
Oh, yeah, man. He's taking a shot, man.
Wow, and then they're selling shirts.
Yeah. Oh, mass. That is pretty dope.
Yeah.
All right. Look at those great shirts. Well, that's very cool. Can they legally fight?
Yeah.
Sure.
They can. Okay.
They're both adults.
Wherever they're from.
I think it's the United Arab Emirates is where the fight is supposed to take place.
Okay.
This is my question. Are they mentally handicapped?
No. Not in any way.
So, let me ask this is a weird question for the audience, for everybody. Would it be inappropriate for somebody to suck their dicks? Like, who is sleeping with Hezbollah?
Somebody had sex with Vern Troyer.
Yeah. But Vern Troyer doesn't look like a child, though. He just looks like a tiny man.
No, Vern Troyer looked more like a child than they did.
I don't know, because they look like children.
Really walk.
Vern Troyer looked like Vern Troyer more than anything else. Like, he looked like he was a very specific look.
Yeah.
They knew he was an adult. They knew he had money.
I am sure that there are
He did
people,
fuck.
There's a lot of fish in the sea. And I'm sure there's someone for both of them.
Giant Squid says no. Patricia Bateman says yes. People saying no,
legally
no,
can.
No,
of
no.
Of course, if they're of age and it's a consensual relationship
no, you could
and the other
their
person's
dick.
Of age.
I'm just saying, would you not, so, would someone, no
the
one
question,
in
you
chat
didn't ask the question.
Them.
You didn't ask the question, would you? You said, is it legal?
Is it appropriate? Well, I think he said, is it appropriate? Because it is legal. It's definitely legal. But is it
There's
appropriate?
A lot of things that are appropriate.
I have no idea. I have no idea. Yeah, illegality does not necessarily equal.
Yeah, they're
morality.
Adults. They're adults.
They're adults.
They're
That's
adults.
The whole point. All right. Well, great, Henry. Thank you so much.
I'm asking a good question. These are
it
real
was
questions.
Not. It
it's
was
an
a
interesting.
Question.
It's an interesting it? Question. It is. It is an interesting debate.
I mean, first
do
of
people
all,
asking do they have baby dicks? I don't know. Probably.
Yeah, I would imagine so. I would imagine they have proportional dicks.
I
that could actually go either way.
That would be truly upsetting if he took off his pants and he had like a fucking 9-inch. Fucking ringer.
It's possible,
like,
man.
If he had like a full on, like, big old purple headed, like, and then it's just this fucking throbbing, horrible thing that's most of his body. He'd probably pass out.
Well, if he got aroused, all the blood would go from his head to his kick.
Well, it's the pube situation people are asking, too.
Well, I don't know what a pube situation is, but you remember Josie?
Yeah, Josie, 9 foot,
with Kid Rock.
3 foot tall with a 10 foot dick. I remember, yeah.
10 inch. A 10-foot dick would be ridiculous. A 10-inch dick. I just re-listened.
I think it's 10 foot. I think it's 3 foot nine with a 10-foot dick.
Eddie and I just
Danny says, I would fuck Mr. Bean, but I wouldn't fuck them.
Well, Mr. Bean is a very wealthy, successful man who is technically very handsome when he's not Mr. Bean.
I was correct. 3 foot nine with a 10-foot dick.
Now, how would that even work, Josie?
This is why he's dead. You can't ask him. He's dead now.
No, I know he died.
Kid Rock
but
murdered that little person.
No, he did not. Kid Rock gave that
People
little
are asking,
guy a time
if it was a
life.
Woman, would it be appropriate? I don't know. It's a good question, everybody. Would you fuck a tiny baby woman that was an LH?
Goodness gracious. There's whole things. The Mighty, I don't even know if I can say the word, but the Mighty Project that the Mighty Little Gal did, and she would take many, many
Oh, she penises. Was incredible, though. She was the quite Mighty a bit, but Project. She was a legitimate little person. But she had, like, a normal people were fucking her all day.
Yes. It's the name of her pornography is Mighty, and then the PC word is Little Person.
People are saying no.
PC word.
People asking where I got this shirt from. It's from Monsters Holding Bitches.
Don't encourage That's this great. Shirt. I actually find this shirt. I looked at him like my father looked at me wearing a Rob Zombie shirt today. I was like, Really? You thought that was appropriate to wear outside of the house?
I'm here. So
look at it, Marcus.
Stream. I can only.
I know.
Wear it on the stream.
I didn't notice it, but yeah, on the stream he can wear it to really like a McDonald's. That. It would be inappropriate at a McDonald's.
It's inappropriate, any really, anywhere. Because if a child looks at that, I think you're a felon.
That's fun.
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Oh yeah, these guys are made for to catch a predator.
Good Lord, they are. They would be great at that. God, they would be great at that.
Well, let's just watch a cute video.
Oh, that's cute. Okay.
Is it possible?
Yeah, some a palate cleanser.
Is it possible eating a donut?
Okay.
To find Tinky.
Love a good possum.
That is really cute. We have a possum that tries to live next to our grill.
Oh my God, look at that possum. Get the fuck out of here.
He's got a cross-eyed.
Possum, you're so funny.
That is cute.
That possum is the funniest thing. His nose is so long, you can probably only see his nose.
Why are they always cross-eyed?
I don't think they always are.
You look like resting.
I think that's just what is. Maybe
that's
some water. He needs water.
Your mouth's not that big, Jinx.
Okay, that's a weird, strange person there.
It's very, very.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
But I like the name. I like the look. It's cute.
It's
the question
because
is, do they stink?
Well, we have a possum that Wendy is very interested in that comes by the house, but we don't feed it or anything, and there's no food for it to be, but it tries to, like, it sleeps next to our back door sometimes. And Wendy goes out and goes like, bam. Like at it, and it doesn't really react, but it's big. Like it's
they are
like,
big.
It's like this big, but it doesn't smell like anything. But I was always kind of afraid that it would like bite Wendy or some shit.
Yeah, it could. It certainly
a possum.
Could.
I think possums
anything with teeth
can
bite.
Yeah, it can't bite. But I don't think possums are aggressive. And that possum is cross-eyed because it's obese. That happens when possums get too fat. They get cross-eyed.
Isn't that something? That is fun for them.
That's such a cute fact.
Wow. Why? I wonder why. Must be something with the glucose.
Apparently a not uncommon problem for pet possums.
That's funny as hell.
They have a buildup of fat deposits in their head that push on their eyes. Pushes their eyes and makes them cross. Painful though. It's not a painful condition.
It's not painful. Okay, good.
And the possum can function normally.
Enjoy the donuts. It's real cute.
People are saying they don't like to attack. People are saying they might have TB though.
Oh, they'll attack. A possum. Yeah.
A possum will attack?
Sure.
Have you had experience with it?
No, but I did carry a big rat in one time in my house in Wheaton, Illinois when I was 5, which is probably about the size of a possum.
They're different,
But that's a rat. That's not a possum.
I know. I'm just saying I would assume a possum has a very dark history and a dark side that we don't know.
I just think
they've had to
maybe
survive this long.
That's
if you're
racism.
An outdoor creature and you've survived this long, you have done something.
Whitney Meyer says possums aren't aggressive and their body temp is too low to incubate rabies.
Well, then why aren't these totally domesticated? Why don't we just have – why do I have dogs and not possums?
I think because they're gross looking.
I mean, an opossum when it shows its teeth, those big sharp teeth, it could be a terrifying animal. It's the tail. That's what it is. It's the naked tail. If it had fur on the tail, it'd be fine. But a naked tail is just—it's not good.
It's not for me. Yep. It's not for me. I like. I think rats can be cute, but also I'm not a big. I'm not a tiny rodent person.
I like a squirrel because I like the hairy tail.
I consider getting rats, but the thing is about a rat is that a rat doesn't live very long, and I didn't like the idea of having something that would die after 2 years. I get really attached to it, and then it would die. I didn't like that idea.
It's like buying a big dog, because like Great Danes die really early, too, and that makes me sad.
Yeah, not 2 years. Well, yeah, but they're all going to die at some point.
Shut up!
Might as well just take care of it while it's alive.
Shut up!
I am with you, though. Do not get a rat. Don't get a rat. They stink.
They can't smell. You got to wash them. Yeah. You got to scrub them. You got to wash the little feet.
I'm traumatized from the rat that I had in Brooklyn, the subway rat that was in my house. It was very malicious.
That's a subway rat. But if you had like a wild dog in your backyard, you would probably have the same idea.
But
if you were chased every day by a wild dog
that tried to kill you. Chased every day?
Yeah, then you get used to it eventually, and eventually becomes, I feel like, the only thing that loves you. Because at least that's looking for you.
Well, you know, it's so weird. With the animal control, they always have all the leashes and stuff to grab the dogs. All you got to do, you roll up a little paper. If a dog sees a rolled up piece of paper, they're going to start changing their activities.
Not if you haven't hit them with it, then they just think you have a paper in your hand.
You boop them on the nose. That's what my dad used to do to my dog.
That's what my parents used to do to me. It was the grabbing by the ear or the hair.
For shitting in the house?
Let's watch an anti-condom, or not anti-condom, a pro-condom ad from India.
Oh, okay, cool.
All right.
I like it.
Protective cover.
And it's got subtitles, too.
Oh, I love it already.
I remember I learned how to do a little bit from Edcina's wedding.
Oh, yes, that's right, the salt shaker.
Yeah.
Oh, that's horrifying. Why is she dressed like the clown from Terrifier?
Man, they got some ballin' music over there. I really
do
like
it. So by the end of this, this song is going to be stuck in your head.
Different fragrance. Do you need a different fragrance?
What?
Like, condom would have a different fragrance.
Oh, you get to, because some of them are the centered and smell ones. So you go, they don't taste good, though. I tasted them. I don't like it.
No.
Oh.
It really takes you through step by step.
It really does.
Everything.
Woo. Never forget me. I'm a condom friend.
Ever useful to you.
Oh, wow.
Some dancing.
Wow, good looking dancing condoms there.
This is actually more than an ad. It's more like a short film.
Yes.
Oh, I love that.
Quite large. Yeah, that's horrifying makeup. Really.
It's kind of fun, though.
Yeah.
The only women we've seen so far are on the covers of the condoms. I do feel like sexy ladies sell the condom more than fellas.
Yeah.
I gotta play this right before making love to my wife.
Oh yeah,
I come in there.
She's gonna love that. Raghavanara. Oh, okay. STIs. Very good. Oh, the condom has a boner.
Oh yeah, you can see that. That's fun.
Wow. I don't think about condoms with boners. There you go.
We're about a quarter of the way through this.
Yeah, we got a long time to go.
That's a long song.
Look at little bottles of water. Maybe they could have done a little bit better with that. Oh, look at that. Now they had a condom together. Oh, it doesn't satisfy their desires.
Well, Bill Gates for years was working on making the new condom.
Really?
He didn't do it. Yeah, that was the whole thing. They were trying to make him feel better.
Okay, do not neglect me. I am a condom.
I am for you. Do not neglect me. I help in stopping unwanted childbirth. That's why you invent it. I save you and I increase your longevity.
That's a nice way of saying numbs it.
I'll remain with you. Never forget me. I am Neuron.
I am Neuron.
I am the condom friend ever useful to you.
These guys have this dance really worked out. This is a multi-location shoot.
It is, man. This is fucking balling, man.
Whoa.
They really like, in India, they like the length, because this whole ad, it's a 7-minute-long ad.
Wow. They like it long.
They're breaking it down.
Hollywood new movies, 3-4 hours long. Incredibly long.
Well, this one's kind of nice, because it's studded for her pleasure.
I wonder, are these guys just sitting there watching it, just like, are they supposed to be there, or are they just in the neighborhood while they're here?
It looks like they're getting horny while watching. The thing is, I would just talk to the makeup artist. Are they? Oh, I see. So they're supposed to be sperm.
They're sperms.
I get it. Did you think about that, Marcus?
Yeah, they're cum inside of it.
They're cum. Yeah.
Oh, they're the cum.
They're the cum.
Wow.
That's why this is art.
Oh, yeah, that's cum. But it actually is proving that the cum is leaving the condom because their arms are outside.
Well, they cut a huge hole in it for their face.
See, that's not good. Yeah, this actually, they shouldn't do that with the condoms.
No.
See, that makes them kind of ineffective.
Well, this is what the conservatives warned us. This is what Teletubbies became. They warned us. Okay.
Man, I love this, and I got really into Fela Kuti as well. Like the idea, I love that.
Oh yeah.
It's so nice. I gotta find good sources of this music.
I can
of
send
what
you
is good.
I can send you a couple of compilations.
Oh, here we go. Now we're getting to a demonstration.
Yeah. That's a
look
nice
rock. Mahogany. Oh, and then you tie it up. That way the lady can't take it out and reinsert the sperm inside of her.
You're talking about arcane.
That happens. That
happens.
Oh, whoa. Whoa.
Whoa.
They are just creative.
I love how smart Ed's smiling. I love this.
I wonder where this was shown. Was it shown on TV? I know it wasn't shown on TV because it gets pretty graphic later on.
It might have been the movie theaters.
This was for sex ed in classrooms. This is you have to sit there in sixth grade and watch this.
This is long. This is very, very long.
There was only a way to cut it off shorter, but we just don't have that ability. Oh, the female condom. Look at this now. They're under the female condom.
Yeah.
No!
I mean, the female condom is the one that, I remember the one that's supposed to protect you from being sexually assaulted, where it's got the barbs in the inside of it.
Yeah.
Up your pussy before you go out.
Like the movie. Oh my god, now we have, oh, gay people also need to use me. Okay, sure.
Very progressive. Like a bat.
Take care of your health. Oh, there the ladies are. Look at that. I am proud of them. This is more fair than many sex education courses in this country.
It is.
Yeah. Actually, we could just show this in every classroom in America and be done.
I just feel like you have more men painted white like cum and wearing giant condom costumes in our schools.
I
think that should be really fun and nice.
I just don't get the fragrance thing. I just don't understand why you need a fragrance condom.
It's the flavored condoms. But
the flavor, I understand, sort of, but the fragrance.
That might be a translation issue.
Yeah.
Oh, could be. Could, because I would think the fragrance might irritate the vagina.
That's what everyone's saying on the chat, being like, the actual having a fragrance would probably cause massive yeast infections.
I always spray Michael Jordan's cologne on my dick right before the action gets really heavy.
Oh, yeah. You always got to do it. Yeah, just so it singes when it goes in.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, great video so far, Marcus. I can tell you really focused this month.
Yeah, you did. I actually am very happy with you. I love your choices.
I literally said a nice sentence.
You did? It sounded very insincere and sarcastic.
It sounded sarcastic.
This is how I'm gonna. This is how it works, though, because in print, I just said, it sounds like you worked very hard this month.
No, this is the problem with print interviews, is that they can say anything, and they take all the context.
Take context out. I'm one of the nicer guys around.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm serious, though. Fantastic videos.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
I'm just trying to kill time.
I'm running
together 13 more minutes.
Just so you know, I'm running extraordinarily low on videos this week. I had 11 videos, but that's the thing is that with Borgir and then pizza and then the mini and then the press conference, I burned 3 real fast and I
did
not think about that.
I tell you what, Borgir and pizza were both worth it because that's like I won and now I will go ahead and see this fight. I feel like we should try to get him for like side stories or something.
I don't think he speaks English.
There's a massive language barrier. Yeah. What on earth would you talk to them about?
Translate. Talk about what's like being, how like we can commiserate about being rageful and small.
Yeah.
Then
we able to identify with you on that.
Because what was that story? I think that was in Arrested Development. But is there any other movie that has like tiny people being thrown at other people to fight? Because it'd be fun to have Hezbollah where you're like fighting with a bunch of dudes. They're like, we got you licked. But they don't know that I got Hezbollah in a fucking bowling bag. And they go back here and I fucking.
You're talking like a toss.
I toss him at them and he's
like
goes,
a little fella toss. They do that in Florida. They do a little fella toss.
I mean,
toss him at a board and they stick up there.
The little person bowling from Wolf came from a story my father told me about how they used to pay little people to come, and they, when they were having parties, they would go and they had have one guy dress up as like, they'd all dress as, they'd put up the bowling pins and the other guy dress up as a like a bowling ball. They put a helmet on him and they put him on a little like little rolly thing,
like a dolly,
but they loved it because they got paid.
Oh, they loved it.
I'm sure they loved it. That's what they had to do to pay their fucking rent.
They loved it.
They were laughing. Should they pour beer on them and stuff?
Oh,
they
that's great.
Loved
I
it.
Loved
you
know, it.
They love being there.
I'm sure your father liked it.
Yeah, Wolf of Wall Street. That's right. Yeah, you guys.
Yep, mm-hmm. Wolf of Wall Street. Yeah. Well, that's great. I mean, I think that they, honest work, if you can get it.
That's...
I was on a show. My first television credit came from me answering a Craigslist ad looking for men with back and chest hair.
Yeah.
That was my first job.
Someone ate sausages off you as a punishment.
Yeah, I'm just saying, like, artists, We've always been just above the sex worker. We've just been right here, right? And it's always been that way because it comes down to you can't have shame. I had one acting teacher.
If you're lucky, you're under the sex worker.
Boink, boink. My acting teacher, my first acting teacher, was like, that was the nicest compliment that he could give. He said, Henry here is perfect for acting because he was born with no shame.
Oh, isn't that nice?
Did he say that in front of an entire class?
Hmm?
Did he say that in front of an entire class?
Yeah, I was held as an example of someone who has no shame.
No shame.
And how did you react, like, later on that night?
Well, because that was when I remember the first time I had ever appeared anything, like, because I was really afraid to show my body. And I was one of those, like, I used to wear, you know, shirt into the pool. I was, like, really ashamed of being very, very large. And then I was doing my first ever sketch with what would become Murder Fist, all those boys. And I would, the hazing rituals that whoever was new had to wear a diaper for the first show.
Oh.
And so I'm sitting there in my diaper,
You guys thought that you guys were cool enough to haze people.
We were having fun, yeah. It was college. I was sitting there and I was like, all right, I'll do this thing. But then I remember one of the senior dudes came in. He's just like, bro, you're fucking hilarious. Your body's funny as hell, man. You're going to go out there and they're going to fucking love when you go out there. You're great. This is hilarious.
That's funny.
And then I remember going out there and in the diaper and it did crush. And I was just like, I have a purpose.
You nailed it. I think that's fantastic.
Yeah.
Honestly.
And then
good for you.
Yeah. Actually, yeah. It ended up being like the Murder Fist sketch that I saw the most. Was the one where you were nude for most of it.
All the time. I saw his balls on more than one occasion. I saw his winky a few times, too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That was good humor. Got you there.
It did.
Ha! Ow! Ow!
Right here, right next to you. I'm right next to you.
The thing is, I did have a thought, but now I think I've lost it. All thoughts are fleeting. Hmm. Isn't that interesting?
That they are. What's forever is felonies.
Well,
let's watch someone committing multiple felonies in an Eastern European airport.
Okay, do they have felonies in Eastern? Oh my God, look at that little car. That's a car where you commit felonies. Oh my God, it's like a little bag.
I want to do this so bad. I want to drive through a fucking mall like so bad.
Stop, sir! Sir!
I like this guy. He doesn't know what to do.
Oh,
he
no,
he
I
knows
don't.
The car's coming. He tries opening the door.
Yeah, you're big man. He doesn't help. Maybe he's just holding on. Well,
okay.
Yes!
Hey. Dude, this is like Blues... not Blues... No, it is Blues Brothers. They drive through the mall. I love the sound. Oh my God.
This is fun as hell.
That is the tiniest little car. Casey Anthony couldn't even use that to hide it. Well, that's sad. Wow, look at it.
This
go.
Was me looking for parking at the Universal lot. It was very funny because I got stuck. Off-road.
It's weird because it looks like it's got modern tech at the airport here, but the car. Is this a modern car?
Man, he doesn't give a fuck.
Wow, he gets through
right
through
the door. That's fucking incredible.
That was great.
If you don't want people to drive through the mall or the airport, don't make the car so small.
Oh, look at that. Go right through the door.
That's incredible.
Look at that. Why are you even running, man? Just call the cops, dude.
Also,
you're not going to do anything.
Are they they're comically running after this car, falling and slipping. Seems like a Benny Hill?
Yeah, man, wait till I get, like, this is me after when I'm 45 in pilot season again. Like, I finally lost my mind after not getting, like, some, like, horrible, stupid, like, pilot called, like...
Hey, man,
Whoa! Dude, this car is... This is just a car commercial for... Oh, no. Okay, go away, buddy!
Yes!
Yeah,
he got away!
Yes!
He got away! My boy!
Yeah!
Hell, you're not gonna catch that car, are you?
That's my boy, man.
No, you didn't get all the way.
He died.
Yeah, the car kind of died. Wow. Well, that is fun. That's always something you fantasize about doing.
I think about it once or twice a week.
Yep.
Especially when I'm in the car.
You know, the way you drive, you might end up going through a building.
Oh, I know when to stop.
Until you accidentally hit the gas.
Oh, wow. Do you guys
know I'm hammered. By then, I deserve what I get.
Oh my God, this guy. Okay, the story behind this, I actually didn't look at this. The story behind this is that he was a Russian drunk driver that was, he told the court he was meeting a lady friend and, quote, fighting for love.
Yes, he is, dude. He is fighting for love.
Honestly,
I got to go, bro. She's gonna go with Dave.
No, you got to drive through the airport to get to her.
I've got to drive because Dave is taking her to a picnic, and I've got to get there before he makes the air.
Well, you know he loved her because he was so nervous he had to get hammered.
He did.
And that means he loved her.
Oh, my Russia. God. Do you know what his sentence was?
I'm going to say 3 months.
15 days.
Oh.
We're wrong.
We actually have to move to Russia.
We're wrong.
How is Russia more
Americans
free than us?
Are wrong. Oh, yeah. This is them. That's like, because that's like a
when
15
was
days.
That, Marcus?
2016.
Wow. Why are we not there? In America? He's away for his life. The rest of his life.
But do you think 15 days in a Russian prison is different? Like,
yeah.
Do you think that you're 15 days inside of a Russian prison and you're just going to feel just, like a year?
Well, I would just say, hey, everyone, slow down while you're Russian. We have all day. You know, because you're confined in a lockup.
In a prison, yeah.
In a jail. 15-day jail. No prison for 15-day. That's jail. Actually, 15 days in jail is not bad.
So much pressure. Just sometimes so much pressure as an adult.
There is a lot of
pressure as an adult to really get in there.
You know? Sometimes you got to drive your car through a damn airport.
Well, according to a report, this guy's name's Nertdinov. he said that he had separated from
his name.
Nertdinov.
That's comedy.
That's comedy. Yeah.
He had separated from his wife and mother of his three daughters, and he'd also lost his job. He was attempting to gain entrance to the airport runway to convince his new flame to stay with him.
Oh.
And when he was asked, why didn't you meet this woman with flowers in the terminal, he said, I was planning to come and meet. Due to the fact that I was harassed, I was forced to do that way. It was planning to come and meet due to the fact that I was harassed. I was forced to do that way.
So they forced him because they were chasing after him. You know, the car is just as scared as you are.
That is that fucking Russian, like, fatalism where they can say that type of stuff. Because you could tell, you could just see him with the sunglasses and the cigarette being like, I would have maybe admitted what I was the way I was meant to do, but you are the ones who made the difference. Like, they were just being like, you were hammered.
Yes, indeed. Well, I hope the lady really respected what he did. He served 15 days for her.
Honestly, she should fucking, that's hot, right?
Yeah. I would say that's, I don't know. Maybe it is. Unless she's leaving forever.
Do you think, because, like, I feel like it'd be different. Because I do feel like you know, your wife. My wife would actually might be they'd like it for a second, but they actually be more mad in the end. But I would find it cool as fuck if Natalie did it for me, or if Carolina did it for you. Wouldn't that be cool as fuck?
It would be cool as fuck.
Again, it would be a colossal pain in the ass. The court dates, the whole you have to take care of everything.
15 days in prison, and he had to pay $91,000 in damages.
$91,000.
You wouldn't take her out of jail and be like, "Baby, I'm giving it to you extra."
You do know they keep people in jail even if you want to take them out, right?
What do you mean?
You don't just go and be like, that one's mine.
No, no.
That's my wife. And then
you
don't
released,
just give him back.
You got to go get him. If you got to go release, you can go get him.
But
or
in
you
America,
him.
She would be, unless she does it in Russia. But.
People are saying it's hot.
In America, it's going to be quite a bit of time. Back.
Honestly, no. In America, because they have to punish you.
Well, and looking up that, I saw that there's actually some St. Pete news. A man crashed through the fencing at the St. Pete Clearwater International Airport, drove his car into the runway, and then got into the cockpit of a Coast Guard aircraft.
Oh, good for him. That's
ambition.
That's called initiative, ambition.
It is.
But you know what it also is? Caught in the line.
Caught
in the line. You got to go to Coast Guard school.
You better go to the fuck. I want you. If you're going to be on a plane, you better go through TSA.
Especially now that they've deputized them so they can kill us.
They can shoot us now.
Oh, wait, the TSA or the Coast Guard?
The Coast Guard and the National Guard have been deputized, so they're allowed to shoot you now?
Oh, they can kill you.
Yeah, they can kill you. And they just got a gun a lot of times.
More people that can kill us.
Civilian army now can kill other civilians.
I think that's actually really cool.
That's just so nice the way that everyone looks.
I want a robot dog!
Well, for another chilling vision of what's to come.
All right.
Let's watch a robot dance.
And we say what's to come as we watch it in real time. It's here.
It's coming. Yeah. I am heartened by this, but I don't need you to fucking act like it's cute. You know what I mean?
It's not cute, it's horrible. You didn't even. I hate this robot.
I think it's kind of cool that it's acting sad and shit.
To let I thought you didn't like grief. I can
really shake he doesn't down. Like grief.
No, you are important.
Supporting him.
All right.
Look, it's cute. The death machine's just dancing. Look, it's cute, Kissel. See, I would prefer more videos.
Give it a fucking cock if you're gonna really do this right.
I would actually prefer more videos of that thing destroying, like, aircrafts and stuff like that. Like, that would be better than this. This does nothing.
So this is just going to come and kill your entire family, and then they're going to hit the music. And then it goes dancing. Yeah. And then it's like, yeah, great.
If it decides to get it instant with it. Yeah. It could be. Oh my God.
Two of them. Kill your whole family.
This is the equivalent of just like looking at George Bush's paintings. Be like, how could he do anything wrong?
Oh, wow. Those three, that's honestly, so cute. That's about probably like close to $100,000 worth of robot.
Oh, more than that.
No,
development goes into it.
No, you'd be surprised. You can buy one of those robot dogs for like 10 G's. Maybe you can get it.
But these guys are the creators of it, so this crossed millions. Also, why did they make the dog, like, so unbelievably horrifying?
Because it's supposed to get bombs. That head is supposed to be used to, like, defuse bombs and get things that it can't go into. That's why you send those guys into hostage situations. So they blitz them with the robot dog shit coming in. Look at that fucking thing. They're gonna act like that's cute. That thing's gonna rip your fucking head off. That thing is, like, that is not a cute machine right there.
That's the only one I like, because it kind of looks like that thing from Toy Story.
Nah, dog.
What is that little dog doing trampling? It's just trampling all over the Constitution!
These dogs.
And our Fourth Amendment rights!
You're looking at the people that are gonna stop the protests of 2022. It's those four things right there. They're gonna roll those things out with like a freedom siren on, and then it's over.
I'm not taking
2025.
Yeah, hold on.
2025, you're right. Because the cops did test the robot dog and then pull it out.
Well, yeah, the people were not happy with it, but they're still bringing it out.
Well, this is a part of the normalization of it.
Exactly. They're just robots. They're just
us. People are trying to say that this is CGI.
Maybe it's both.
Maybe it's CGI?
I don't think it's CGI.
I don't think it's CGI.
I don't know,
either,
but people are saying it's CGI. They're all saying whatever.
Well, if people said it. I believe that is not CGI because I've seen so many robot videos.
Well, there was a video of them dancing that I know is real. But those are the guys that are going to get you.
Yep, absolutely.
Right here. Because they can't. I don't think they can cross the legs like that.
I don't know, dude. Why couldn't they? I think they can. I think Boston Dynamics. Deal. Oh, thank you for giving the credits.
Yes, because they had to.
Isn't that nice? Boston Dynamics, the Terminator, the place that Terminator will return to when he has to steal back.
100% authentic.
There you go.
One
wow! Listen, 100% to, we gotta authentic. Be. We gotta, Marcus. We gotta make sure to vet Henry over here. He's just taking the chat. He's just trying to doing his due diligence.
I'm throwing it all out there.
Also, the answer to that song is no, robot. How about that? Unless you save my life, thank you.
We're gonna find out. It's gonna come for all of us.
I know
but also
they
the same
can
time,
do some good things.
I am gonna have one. My goal is for me to have some of these robots.
But you know, oh my God.
Equalize.
Well, they're already going full AI. They're going to kill us.
I'm getting one.
They're sentient.
Once they decide we're a threat, then it's all going to be
over. They're already using them in Palestine. The Israelis are using them.
You want to
start doing this now?
We have some. That's why LPN needs some.
Oh my God.
We need some robot dogs for the network.
All right, y'all. We're going to go have old man yell at each other corner, but we'll have to end the stream. Thank you all so much for watching this week. Hope you guys are doing good. We're not going to be – well, I guess it doesn't matter. We'll be around.
Oh, yeah. We're taking 2 weeks off, and we'll be back. We know we're doing this at the very end. We're taking 2 weeks off. We'll be back.
Yeah.
The last podcast – all the other shows are going to be up and going, but us as humans are going to not be here, so the shows will
be – replaced with robots. Hail yourselves, everyone.